man, secret exit. Jeez. All right, we'll go for a few more. Are there gonna be new Pokemon in the new Pokemon game? Is that what I'm to understand? New ones we haven't seen? Like those three new starter ones, that like green kitty, are they new? Are those new friends? So I'm not as up on the Pokeverse. My knowledge of Pokemon honestly goes literally as far as red and blue, the original red blue, and some of the other ones like I still refer to Meryl, the Pokemon Meryl, as Pika Blue, because there was a time when that was all we knew that Pokemon as. So, my knowledge, and for it, and some of the new ones that I've seen, because I watched Skytree play Sword and Shield. They had like 100? Oh man, there's going to be so many new Pokemon. See, I'm excited about that. Like, I don't really want to play the game to find out what they all are, but I will watch my friends play it and find out about what the Pokemons are. I think Hope Furret is in this one. Furret has really been not sort of passed over for a lot of the previous Pokemons, and I would appreciate it if they would include. Just a thought, dear Nintendo, please put Furret in the next one. Right, Pikablue. I like that name too. It's just Pikablue. And then it's like, oh, this Pokemon's called Meryl. I'm like, what the fuck is Meryl? What is this Meryl shit? It's just Pikablue. What is this Meryl? I know of no Meryl. I mean, Pokemon came out when I was in elementary school. I remember, like, I was the target audience for that. That was our generation. We got the very first Pokemon trading Pokemons with the Game Boy freaking Link cable. Physically have to link the two together with a goddamn USB cord, basically. And it's not even a USB cord, it's some proprietary-ass shit. Trading Pokemon that way, the original Missingno. That was one of the first, I'll be real, that was, Missingno was one of the first glitches I ever did to exploit and win at the game more. I'm pretty sure Missingno might have actually been my first experience, like, breaking a game to my advantage in a meaningful way, because you could duplicate the sixth item in your slot or whatever, so I got, like, infinite revives and potions and whatever I wanted. How we all learned how to do that was the early days of the internet. I mean, I got mine from the internet. Some of the first uses I ever had for the internet were, I didn't even have it at my house, but my neighbor had it. Good old Biff. That's not his real name. But my neighbor, I made that up. My neighbor Biff had it, and I would go over to his place, and we would look up GameWinners.com and print out cheat codes and stuff for Pokemon, and that was where I encountered Missingno. After a billion failed attempts at pushing the SSN and getting Mew. Although it is validating that Mew is possible. If If I could time travel, I would go back to the, like, 1993 or whatever, 95. I don't remember when Pokemon came out. But I would time travel back, and I would post a full write-up on how to get Mew for real on the 90s internet. And freaking no one would ever know how I did it. But it turns out there is actually a glitch that you can do on a real Pokemon Red Blue cartridge to actually get Mew. And none of the sites knew what it was at the time, but it turned out to be real. I like that. I feel validated in that. That sounds cool. I know folks have done that. I was in the Cub Scouts as a kid, but I was never, I quit. I didn't really want to do it anymore. I was in, you know, it's come to think of it, I don't know if it was my parents or what, but, like, if they signed me up for it or if I, like, as a kid wanted to do it. But I was in, like, a lot of, like, group-type things that I just, like, lost interest in completely as a kid. I never became a Weebolo. But I did do the Pinewood Derby. That was fun as hell. I want to get my friends together and have a friend Pinewood Derby. I know my buddies would go for it. We could make it a thing. I want to do it at, like, maybe at a show. I'm for real about this. I want to do a show this summer that is like a show, a combination show and Pinewood Derby. And you have to build a Pinewood Derby car. You have to bring it, and then we have, like, a prize, and then, like, the bands play, and then, like, there's, like, different heats and races, and you race your Pinewood Derby car. Wouldn't that be awesome? Wouldn't you definitely go to a cool rock and roll show that also invited you to participate in the DIY Pinewood Derby? I know I would. In fact, I will, because I'm going to have it. I will make it be a thing. I'm not doing a bit anymore. I'm just talking about my plans for the summer. I just kind of think whittling seems fun. I've never really, like, done it. I mean, the principle is fairly sound. I mean, whittle, that's it. But I've never, like, done it. It just seems kind of neat. I want to whittle something. Yeah, right? It does. I like those little pine cars. Right? You go to the show, and then you get to see the bands. And maybe, you know, you get a beer at the door, and you get to see the bands, and you get to race the Pinewood Derby cars. It'd be awesome. It'd be so fun. And all the bands could, like, enter their own car, and you could decorate them, and it'd be all funny and junk. Yeah. Whoa. Honestly, one of my favorite things about doing the whole punk rock jam back in the day was, like, punk rock themed fun days. You know, punk rock fun day at Kennywood. We'd all, like, dress up and go to Kennywood. Punk rock day at the movies. Like, we would, like, have, like, events like that. And they were all super fun. And I miss that, like, officialness of having, like, official punk rock Pinewood Derby car night. Like, damn. I'm bringing it back, dude. I'm doing it this summer. This is a call to action. I'm having a Pinewood Derby combo show. Let's go. GG. Good level. That was an easier one. Dang, I figured we'd spend the rest of the night on that level. There's a secret.